Hello everyone, assalamu alaikum. In this tutorial we'll learn how to build a multilingual Laravel website. Well, this is my website domain and it's alive now, it's on the server. Now here we want to build a simple website where we'll have menus, different menus for languages, and we'll tap on the menus and switch between the languages. That's what we want to do. Well, to do that we'll use one cool function in Laravel that's in our web.php file, and over here we'll define our route group. Well, it's not here yet, we'll do that. Now let's take a look at our web.php file. Well, web.php file is under app directory within routes directory web.php. okay, come to app and then find routes, and then it will say this file. Now here we have only one route, which is to the home page, and it has a view defined over here. It doesn't really have any dedicated controller or model defined to attach to it, so that's one thing we need to know. And the view is actually coming from the resources view folder over here. Okay, so that's the default view you get after installation. So the first thing we'll do, we'll define our route group over here, because we will use route group and namespace to switch between different languages. And the blade files for our views would be stored over here for different languages. Well, this is a little bit different approach. Basically, when you see to make a multiple Laravel website or multi-language Laravel website, a lot of time they do and store the languages in key pair values. I personally find that's quite annoying because you have to do a lot of work. So over here we'll take a different approach to build our multi-language Laravel website. Anyway, so the first thing, as I said, the first thing we need to do is go ahead and create different namespace for our controllers. Okay, so that's the first thing you want to do, and then we'll find those controllers in our web.php file. So now let's open up a terminal. So I'm in the root folder of my Laravel application, as you can see from here. And over here, first what I will do, I'll create controllers. Now I'll create two different controllers for our two languages. Well, we'll have English and Chinese. Well, now over here in the HTTP folder, you'll see there is a controllers folder. So within this folder, we'll create another two folders. Okay, and we can do that easily from our command line. Well, we'll do PHP artisan make controller en index controller. So using this command, what it will do, it will create a folder and name it en for English language. That's what we want to define. And then within this controller, it will create a controller called index controller. Okay, well, if it doesn't exist, it will create this folder. If it exists, it will only create this index controller. Okay, so let's hit enter, and you'd see it says it created successfully. All right, now we can view it that it did. So over here, I'll come over here and refresh it. Now I'll open up our HTTP folder, controllers folder, and then you see we see our en folder. Okay, now within it we have index controller, and interestingly, you'll see the top line over here, it already defined the namespace for this index controller, which is en. Well, that's the default one for every controllers. Now here en is the most important keyword or part for our case. So it created one index controller under this namespace. Well, now we'll use this index controller for our English language. Now we'll go ahead and create another controller, and we'll do it for a different namespace. We'll call it ZH, which is for Chinese language. Well, I'm fluent in Chinese anyway, so as you can see, my editor is in Chinese. So I'll hit enter, Now it will create another controller. So what we'll do, we'll go ahead and refresh it one more time. And now if we open up the HTTP and controllers folder, we'll see two folders. One is for EN, another is for ZH. So this is for ZH. And as you can see, the route namespace, sorry, the namespace is also mentioned over here. So if you generate controllers like this, it will automatically put the namespace within your controller. Okay, so now here we'll come back to our web.php file over here. Well, for now we don't need this anymore. Now what we'll do, we'll go ahead and define our route group, because within the route group we'll use our namespace en and the namespace zh. That's what we'll use. Okay, so here we'll write, here we'll write route group. Now route groups takes two parameters. First one is the array and second one is a callback function. Okay, well, within array we'll define our namespace. Okay, so here we'll write namespace and it'll point to a namespace. In our case, the first namespace is en for English language, which will so it'll point to this namespace over here. Okay, so now within it we'll mention our controller, okay, or actually the route. So we'll have our first route, so we do route.get, and then we'll define for this namespace the home page. So we'll do that using a slash, and after that here we'll define our index controller, the controller, and this controller points a method, and that would be index method. Well, for now we don't have this method yet. Okay, so we'll go ahead and create. Now here of course we'll save it. Okay, so here we already have this index controller and then index, so we need to create index this method. So we'll come to our English namespace, controller for English language over here, which is actually this one. Yes, this is open. So now over here we'll define our method. So our method would be a public method. We'd do public function index, and now here we'll simply return a view. Okay, and our view's name is welcome. Yeah, that's all. Okay, now we'll save it. Okay, so now what we could do, we could come to our website over here. Now let's refresh it and see the result. Now here it says that target class controller en index, well, that doesn't exist. Okay, so now it's saying that it doesn't exist. Now for this one, there are a few different ways to solve this issue. Okay, now one of the ways that I would do, because we'll have multi-language, so we'll come over here to our provider class, over provider folder, and here we have route service provider. We'll come over here, and here actually you see there is a line that's commented out, this one. As you can see, it says that controller namespace for application, when present, controller route declaration will automatically prefixed with this namespace. So for all of our controllers, the default namespace is this one, right? Yeah, so we'll uncomment it over here. And well, this is a greater benefit, because if we use multiple languages, and multiple languages will have different controllers, and all of their default namespace would be coming from here. Okay, so what we'll do, we'll go ahead and save it. Now we'll come over here, and actually we don't need to add anything over here. Now what we'll do, we'll go ahead and refresh it. Yes, now it's working. Okay, well, the other way, it could be like here, actually you define the namespace directly, and that should work too, but that wouldn't work for our multi-language application. Okay, so the better way to do it, just uncomment it here. Okay, now that's so far so good with our English language. And what about the Chinese language? Okay, so now for Chinese language, what we'll do, we'll go ahead and copy it, put it right there. Do remember, for Chinese language, the namespace is ZH, okay? So that is our namespace, all right? Now, over here, one thing I would like to tell you one more time. So this is the default namespace that we get. And over here, it'll tag ZH or EN based on whatever route you want to access, okay? So now, for Chinese language, the default homepage, definitely not this one. This is for English. So for Chinese language, we'll create another, for homepage, we'll create another route and we'll call it ZH slash or just like this. It would work as well. Now we'll save it. Now we'll come over here and here we'll define a function for index method like this one. Actually, you can call it any name, it doesn't really matter. So we do public function index. Now here we'll return a view. Now we want to return a view, a different view than the view of this one. Okay, so now that view would live under this resources views folder, but we already have one over here. That's for English language. So what we'll do, we'll go ahead and create a new folder over here and we'll call it ZH, okay? And within new folder, ZH, we'll create another file and we'll call it welcome.blade.php, okay? Now, for our blade, we have this little static file over here. Actually, I don't want to use it. I will use a different one, which I already have. So I'll just select all of them and copy paste the default view that I have. It's from Bootstrap, as you can see from here. It doesn't matter whatever you use, but this is just for demonstration purpose. Now we'll save it. Okay. Now we'll save the same for our Chinese language. Okay, so this is Chinese language blade. We'll save it. Now, what we'll do here, we have this, you see, it called Chinese project. And for this one, well, I wanna call it, say, project English, okay? All right, yeah. And now what we'll do, we'll go ahead and refresh it. And as you see, the view changed. Now this is the default view for our English language, okay? Now we need to change the button over here. We'll call it Chinese, okay? So I'll call it here Chinese. And now do remember from web.php file here, for Chinese language, the home page route is ZH. So we'll copy this one and put it over here. Okay, now what we'll do, we'll go ahead and refresh our website over here. Now it changed to Chinese. Now as you see, if I hover over on this, at the left bottom part, we can see a route which was over here. You see it again. I hover over and you see that. So it's pointing to a different route, okay? All right, now we'll click on this. But of course, it says that this doesn't exist. Well, it says that the controller and index method doesn't exist. Well, that's because over here we did create, but we did not save it. So I'll save it. Now it's saved, as you can see over here. Now I'll go ahead and refresh it. Now I think we have some grammar issues. So let's go ahead and find it and over here. So now over here, we want to return a different view for Chinese language. So do remember, we created another view under ZH folder. So to access this view, we'll just simply go ahead and write ZH dot and welcome. Using this one, we'd be able to access the welcome view from ZH folder, okay? So now I'll go ahead and save it. Now refresh it one more time. And yes, it's gone. Now, as you see, they have different route over here, or URL. Now, over here, we want to go back to our English language, okay, by clicking on this one. So now it goes back to English language, and the menus, it changes automatically, okay? Yeah. Well, interestingly enough, you can actually create more buttons for each of them, okay? Now, over here, what I'll do, I'll create another file. It would be for, say, about, okay? Now, we are in English language, so for English language, I'll come over here under this view, I'll create another file, and I'll call it, say, about.blade.php. Now, to be simple and quick, I'll just go ahead and copy paste this one, and over here, we don't need this owner, so I'll close this. And we also, let's see, well, I'll just keep all of them for now. Now over here, so this would be the about page. Now let's see, what are the things we can change? So over here, we'll just change a little bit of this information. So here, we'll say learn programming with the best tech, okay? Yeah, we want to make programming easy for everyone. Okay, so that's what we'll have. Okay, now of course we need to create the Blade file has been created. Now we need to create a method for this. So this is our English language controller. So over here, we'll create a method. So we'll call it about. We'll just go ahead and copy paste this. So we'll call it about. Now the blade for this is about as well. Now we'll save it. Now over here, we'll come back to our web.php file. We'll define a different route for this about page. So we'll do about. Now over here, once again, we'll do index controller at about. Okay, so this is our about page. And what else you could do? You can change the title for this. You could say about. Yes, I think that's pretty much it. Okay, so I'll save it. Now here we'll refresh it. Okay. But now if you click on this, of course it didn't work because we need to change the menu option from our about page over here. So here we'll just simply write about, okay? So now go ahead and refresh it one more time. Okay, now you click over here. Now as you can see from the left bottom side over here, so our route is there. So we'll just go ahead and click on this. Now, learn programming with the best tech. We want to make programming easy for everyone. Of course, you get the idea. So based on your routes, the one you defined, the one you defined over here, you can also change the routes in navigation folder, but it still doesn't impact our Chinese language site. So I went ahead and quickly made some changes. This welcome.blade file. So these are all in Chinese right now, pretty much. Okay. Now, if you come to the front end, now you see this is for Chinese language and this is for English language. Now we can switch the languages just like that. Okay. So thank you guys.